For more on what Google's plan to pull out of China means for U.S.-China trade, it's a story we've been following for a couple of days now. We have to join us William Reinsch, the former U.S. Undersecretary of Commerce and current president of the National Foreign Trade Council. He is joining us from Washington right now. And we should add that he's also a member of the U.S.-China Economic and Security Review Commission, which submits reports to Congress on national security implications of U.S. economic relations with China. So quite a mouthful there. Mr. Reinsch, thank you for joining us this morning. I want to ask you, was the hacking incident into Google's China website and Google's subsequent threat to leave China a turning point in any way for U.S.-China trade relations?
Well, I think it dramatizes a growing set of problems that a lot of companies have had there. As your previous report just indicated, their government is really taking steps in an anti-market direction. More subsidies, more national champion industries, continuation of an export-led growth strategy, overvaluation of their currency. I think you're seeing more and more American companies frustrated and rethinking the nature of that relationship. And certainly there's going to be more pressure on the U.S. government to rethink it. The Google episode, which is a little bit of a special case because of the services they provide, nevertheless, I think dramatizes that and has forced companies to pause a little bit and think a lot more carefully about where that relationship is going for them.
So Google's stance could become representative of how U.S. companies are doing business in China might start standing up for themselves.
Well, I think in a large sense, yes. I don't expect a lot of companies to pull out. Google, in that sense, is a special case. They have under special pressures from the Chinese government. I would look going forward for new investment increasingly to go somewhere else.
Like where?
I would guess India, probably India, Brazil, other big markets.
So other BRIC countries?
Yes.
Okay, China, in its defense, probably feels that it has the right to call the shots if you're doing business in its country, and it's probably earned it to a large extent by being the biggest creditor to the U.S., the U.S. government really not having a lot of leverage here.
Well, I'm sure their government thinks that. If you talk to their economists, and you talk economist to economist, I think their prescription for the Chinese economy is really the same as American and European economists. They ought to revalue the RMB. They ought to pursue a domestic growth consumption strategy. They ought to try to get their state-owned enterprises under control rather than increase their subsidies. And they ought to not be producing more and more regulations that discriminate against foreign products and foreign services. That doesn't mean the government there listens to their economists any more than other governments listen to their economists. So yeah, I think they feel that way. Companies, have to make their own judgments about what's in their interest. And my sense is they're going to begin to reevaluate that.
But bottom line, Mr. Reinsch, can companies in the U.S. really afford to stand up to China? For instance, with Google, it can get tit for tat very quickly. For instance, the launch of its Android phones in China were delayed.
Well, you're exactly right. And the Chinese have a pattern here of tit for tat retaliation. Nothing you do goes unpunished in China. And that's something that companies have to consider carefully. There's been a long history the last 10 years of companies not standing up. I think the Google episode suggests that companies may begin to take a different view now and begin to look more at the long-term interests they have rather than short-term profit.
Taking a step back here, how has the global financial crisis and this great recession changed the way the Chinese government deals with U.S. companies, their strategy with dealing with foreign companies?
Well, I think I'm not sure the recession has changed the way they do it. I think the current government, the Hu Jintao, Wen Jiabao government, has taken some steps back from the previous Chinese administration, as I said, in an anti-market direction. We felt 5 years ago they were moving in a market opening direction. They were using WTO accession to actually get their own ministries to step up and open the markets and produce sort of country-neutral regulations. The current regime seems to be going backwards, and they're moving much more in a market-controlling direction, supporting state-owned enterprises. This new indigenous innovation concept they've come up with, essentially favorable treatment for technology and innovation that is homegrown in China, continued efforts, either through hacking, you know, illegal efforts or legal efforts to acquire technology from the West, all has people concerned here.
Okay. Thank you for your thoughts. That's all the time we have for you. We've been speaking with William Reinsch, the president of the National Foreign Trade Council over in Washington.